What's up, everybody? So, in this video, I'm going to be making the gun holster and the two hand plates for my Mandalorian costume. As usual, I start off by tracing the pattern. I'm tracing this onto 2mm craft foam. I am going to be doing two layers of 2mm. My past couple builds, I've been doing that. I don't have any 4mm foam, so I have been gluing two pieces of 2mm together to make 4mm. It's a lot more annoying than just cutting one piece out of 4mm, but you gotta make do with what you got. All the pieces are labeled in the blueprint. Some of them have to be taped together. They're all labeled which pieces go together. And they're all labeled how thick they're supposed to be, too. So I trace those all out. And then I just go through and I cut them all out. There's no beveled cuts on any of these. It's all just straight cuts, which makes it a little bit quicker. You can just kind of use a ruler and sharp knife and just slice through them. So I'm just making sure that those two pieces I cut out will fit together properly when I glue them together. Just making sure that my template has enough room on both pieces. And so you put contact cement on both sides and then just stick it together. And then this is the actual piece that goes on the belt. This also is 4mm, so I'm just gluing my two templates together. And then I cut the middle out. And then I go around and I cut all of the excess off all the way around the pattern. Now I'm just folding it in half and making sure that it is the same on both sides, because this part gets glued together and then this gets glued onto the back of the holster. And so I'm just making sure that it's square and that it looks good. Now I'm cutting out the holster itself, just using a sharp knife and just going around the edges as best as I can. I use a rotary tool, like usual, just to clean up the cut mark all the way around the edge and just shape it a little bit better. That's more of a preference. You don't necessarily have to do that if you get a good cut. I just like to add a little bit of a bevel and clean it up a little bit just for visual details. So then you see how that folds over to the front there, and that creates your pocket for the gun. This is a piece of 10mm foam here that I'm using to cut out this side detail. I don't know exactly what it's for, other than just to look futuristic in sci-fi, I guess. So it's just this kind of triangle piece here that I'm just cutting on a 10 millimeter. So now I'm using that tin foil technique again that I kind of did in the other video. Just crumple up some tin foil, unfold it, and then put it on your foam and just run a iron over the top of it. You don't have to sit on it for a long time, just it's hot enough to... You can see how it's hot enough where it kind of sticks, and then you just peel it off. And it gives you a really nice, like, organic detail. I do that on the holster on all the pieces that you will see. So the top square there on the front, you see, but you don't see the inside. So I do that on that, and I do it on the front that you see when it folds over. And now I'm just going through with some contact cement, and I'm just gluing the sides, just putting glue on the sides of the holsters. Not a lot, just maybe a centimeter in on the border. You can see I kind of pre-marked that curve on the top there, right above where my thumb is. That's the other side where I want the other side to be on the top. And then so with the belt holder here, I do the same thing. I put on the back of it, I put glue on both of the square pieces right to that pen mark. That's where the glue goes. My contact cement is pretty much done. I bought a new can in the middle of this video, and you'll see the difference when I open up that new can in a minute. Alright, so now that the glue on the holster is tacked up, I am going to glue it together. I'm just going to carefully fold it, and I attach it to the top piece where my mark is. Slowly work your way down to the bottom corner. Alright, now I'm just gluing that belt piece to itself. I'm just starting in the corner, and then work my way up to the top line, so I know that side is set, and then I will slowly put the bottom together evenly, then match that corner, and then that is pretty much it. That should be pretty much exact. If you can get the corners and the sides lined up, then the rest of it should just kind of fold right into place. So you can see now how that makes that belt loop, where the belt will go through it. So now I'm just using my gun and putting it in the holster just to check for fit. This pistol I made a while ago, I didn't make a video on it. It's from, I got the template and the stuff from SKS Props. I will put a link to his channel in the description. He has the free template and a really great video on how to put it together. So I will give you that link in the description to check that out. This is the side detail. I'm just marking where I want it to go. I do all that with the gun in the holster just so I know exactly where it has to go. If you do it beforehand and then put the gun in there, it might shift it over, it might stretch it and not be exactly where you want it. So I just glue that on with some contact cement. I think it, and the real thing, it's supposed to go underneath the one layer of leather and be like a under detail, but with foam it doesn't really matter. You can get the same visual effect just by doing that. And this is the strap. I'm just trying to get a idea of where the strap goes, so I put the strap through and I mark where the top holder needs to be. And when I glue this in, I use super glue, and I just put a really tiny amount on the sides so that the center won't glue, obviously, to the bottom, because you want your strap to go through there. So I marked out here where the strap needs to go. I cut a slit and I feed this strap in through the back. The pattern I made for you guys, I left that strap really long, so you have plenty of extra. And I'm using just a picture of the holster to get an idea of exactly how far down that strap goes, and just put it where I like it. And then you can put glue on the back of your strap and glue that down into place. And that's pretty much it for the strap. Now I'm so that's that new jar of contact cement. You can see how light it is compared to the other one, and it spreads so much better. I don't know why I always wait so long to get new glue, but it's very worth it to have fresh contact cement when you're doing stuff. And I'm just putting it on both sides of the back of the holster and the back of the belt loop. And this is my patented technique of using the pieces to fan dry the glue, because I'm pretty impatient. So then I'm just lining that up, gluing that on. Making sure it lines up. Alright, and then now I put the gun in again and I put the strap in. Make sure the strap is going to work. And that's the holster. It's kind of hard to see all that leather detail in this stage, but once you paint it, you will see for sure. Once you do the wash, you can really tell that there's a texture, a nice pattern. Now I am using just some dark brown. I believe it's the same brown I used for the other leather strap for my leg armor. And I paint the entire thing with that. After I put I did three layers of Mod Podge like I usually do. I show it in every video. I just didn't feel like showing it in this video. Put three layers of Mod Podge on, then you put your paint on top. And so with this, I'm painting to cover, but I'm also not trying to get it like 100% coverage. The streaks and the way that the paint goes down with one coat, to me, looks more realistic. Leather's not really uniform. You know, it's not just one solid color. It's not a block color. It has a lot of different textures and tones, and so that's kind of what I try to do. Just by putting one coat on, you can kind of get that if your paint covers pretty good, like this paint does. This is a plaid paint. I believe it's the Folk Art brand. It's just a dark brown, and I'm using that to paint all the edges, all the insides. And now I mixed up some black acrylic paint with some water for a wash, a black wash, and I'm just mopping that on with a big brush. You've seen me do washes before, but you put a lot on so it gets into all the cracks and crevices, and especially all that like texture that you put in with the tin foil. And then I use my rag here and I just mop around, and just this takes up paint, and it also creates another like pattern by dabbing the paint around. Now, what I'm doing is the same thing I did on my leg armor. I'm just using this lighter brown. I'm going around and I'm hand painting all of the stitches. This is sped up like 550%. This takes a while to do this. But again, I think it gives a really good look to the finished product. It makes it look good from a distance and even up close. So I paint all the stitching where all the stitching would be if it was leather. There'd be double stitching around this piece because it's a stress point, and the stitching on here, which holds, it would hold this leather piece to the back leather piece. It's pretty much the same. The way that I glued everything together with the foam is pretty much exactly how like the leather would be glued and sewed together. So the stitching just kind of, I'm just using the stitching to pretty much show like where I glued stuff onto the foam. So it looks realistic in that way. And I put all the stitching even on the back, even though you're not going to see it. I was just doing it, and I was on a roll, so I just kept going. This is a little bit of that dark paint mixed with a little bit of that light paint. Just going around and dry brushing all of the high parts and parts where it's going to rub, you know, like pulling the gun in and out is going to rub the outside of the leather. The strap going in and out there is going to rub. So all this is doing is just, it's just putting a little bit of a dry light brush on all of the parts where it would crack or get worn or get rubbed. Alright, so now we will start working on the hand plates. This is a piece of 2mm foam. I cut the inside pattern out, the detail part, and cut all that out of foam. That takes a while because there is a lot to cut out, and these are pretty small lines. But if you use a smaller X-Acto knife, you can just take your time, make sure you cut all the corners. Again, I'm using 2mm foam that I'm gluing together to make 4mm foam. I really need to get some 4mm foam. Now I am marking the full plate pattern. The pattern I made isn't in half for you guys, it's just that this is the work in progress pattern for me. So cut that plate out, mark on the back where the folds go. And I'm using a 45 degree cut on the back to make a V channel. Cutting that out of the back so that you can put contact cement in those channels and glue it together, and it makes a permanent 45 panel line. So I use contact cement here, and I am gluing these pieces together. That's my old can of contact cement because I did this before I finished that other piece, so it's just the magic of editing, I guess. I wish I had the new stuff when I was doing this. This is pretty tricky to put on. It's really easy for it to stick in the wrong spot and not be able to unstick it. I made three of these all together. The first one I made, it looked pretty bad, and it was a trial, basically a trial piece. This triangle piece here goes in the middle, and then there's that square piece on the template you guys will see. It goes on the back for this raised square detail on the back. And then this square detail piece here gets sanded down with the rotary tool all the way around to create a bevel. You might be able to cut a 45 degree bevel out when you cut it out. I just sometimes my cuts aren't great, and I felt like it would have been a lot better off just doing it with a Dremel. This is just some tan paint that I have in a spray can. It's a camo. It's for like desert camo. I thought it looked pretty good, so I used that. I put Mod Podge on these again, three coats Mod Podge, and then I spray painted them. Then when they dried, I mixed up some of this blue, this light blue paint, painted the triangles, and then I mixed up some dark brown with some water, and I did a wet wash of that, like muddy color, and I put on the whole thing, and I dab it off. These aren't super weathered. In all the reference images I see, they're not super weathered, but a little bit of weathering goes a long way. Using the Sharpie to mark some of these chips. In the reference images and things that I've seen, I see a lot of black mark. I don't know if they're supposed to be like burn marks or scar marks or whatever, but I use the Sharpie and I just make some black marks, and then I take some silver tester's paint and I mark inside of the Sharpie, leaving some of it exposed. And that's it. So thanks everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please subscribe, hit the like if you liked. Check out my Instagram and my Facebook page, where all my templates are free for you guys. And I will see you next time.